At least 6 Palestinians have been killed in Gaza's southern city of Rafah, according to the Palestine Red Crescent Society, as Israeli forces intensified their operations in Shujaya and Rafah. Israeli tanks fired shells at homes in Shujaya and Rafah, trapping families inside amidst heavy bombardment. The United Nations estimates that 60,000 to 80,000 people have been displaced from Shujaya in recent days. Residents describe living conditions as a hell, with constant airstrikes making it dangerous to leave their neighborhoods. In Gaza City, central areas have also suffered heavy bombardment. Al Jazeera reported that makeshift tent camps in the Al-Nawasi district, deemed safe zones by Israel, were set ablaze. Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu reiterated his commitment to continue the offensive until all objectives are met, including eliminating Hamas and ensuring security for Israeli residents.
אני פה עם חטיבה 55, חטיבת חוד החנית, תרגיל חטיבתי. מאוד מרשים ביכולות, בהתגייסות, בהתייצבות, כושר הביצוע, כושר ביצוע גדול מאוד של החיילים והמפקדים שבאים מכל חלקי הארץ, מכל חלקי החברה הישראלית ונחושים ודבקים במשימה להגן על המדינה ולהשיג ניצחון.
Meanwhile, ceasefire talks have shown no progress according to senior Hamas official Osama Hamdan, despite ongoing international mediation efforts.
إننا نتابع بأسف موقف الإدارة الأمريكية التي تصر بلؤم كبير على تحميل حركة حماس مسؤولية تعطيل التوصل للاتفاق. على الرغم من ترحيب حماس بما ورد في خطاب بايدن من تأكيد على وقف إطلاق النار الدائم والانسحاب الشامل والإعمار والتبادل وعلى الرغم أيضا من ترحيب حماس بقرار مجلس الأمن بهذا الخصوص فيما لم يسمع العالم أي موافقة أو أي ترحيب من أي مسؤول في حكومة الاحتلال لا بخطاب بايدن ولا بقرار مجلس الأمن.
In the West Bank, one Palestinian was killed and 5 wounded in an Israeli strike near Tulkarim. Hamas and Palestinian Islamic Jihad reported fierce fighting in Shujaya and Rafah, with exchanges of rockets and mortar bombs against Israeli forces. The humanitarian situation in Gaza continues to deteriorate, with severe shortages of aid, medicine, and fuel exacerbating the crisis. The UN and relief agencies have expressed grave concern over the dire conditions facing Gaza's 2.4 million people. Louise Wateridge from UNRWA described the situation as catastrophic, with widespread destruction and minimal access to basic necessities.